Ivrim, chapter 3. Therefore, set apart brothers, partakers of the heavenly calling, closely consider the emissary and high priest of our confession, Messiah Yahushua, who was trustworthy to him who appointed him, as also Moshe in all his house. For this one has been deemed worthy of more esteem than Moshe, as much as he who built the house enjoys more respect than the house. For every house is built by someone, but he who built all is Elohim. And Moshe indeed was trustworthy in all his house as a servant, for a witness of what would be spoken later, but Messiah as a son over his own house, whose house we are if we hold fast the boldness and the boasting of the expectation firm to the end. Therefore, as the set-apart Spirit says, today if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion, in the day of trial in the wilderness, where your fathers tried me, proved me, and saw my works 40 years. Therefore, I was grieved with that generation, and said, they always go astray in their heart, and they have not known my ways, as I swore in my wrath, if they shall enter into my rest. Look out, brothers, lest there be in any of you a wicked heart of unbelief in falling away from the living Elohim. But encourage one another daily, while it is called today, lest any of you be hardened by the deceivableness of sin. For we have become partakers of Messiah, if we hold fast the beginning of our trust firm to the end. While it is said, today, if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion. For who, having heard, rebelled? Was it not all who came out of Mitzrayim, led by Moshe? And with whom was he grieved 40 years? Was it not with those who sinned, whose corpses fell in the wilderness? And to whom did he swear that they would not enter into his rest, but to those who did not obey? So we see that they were unable to enter in because of unbelief,